That's great. Hello, I'm Ken Burns, award-winning documentarian behind The Civil War, available on VHS and DVD at pbs.org. As much as I'd love to be there right now with you, learning a great deal about Abraham Lincoln, I can't, as I'm currently condensing the actions of a different war into my next film. However, through my access to materials accumulated during my research for The Civil War, which is currently available on VHS and DVD at pbs.org, I'd like to contribute to Log Cabin Dreams and hopefully provide insight into the horrors of battles where man turned against his brother, father against son. Little information outside of newspaper accounts of the day has found its way into the public conscious. But through letters from the front lines, we have the words of soldiers in their own language, sometimes coarse, almost always uneducated. Many of these letters never found their addressees, lost in the fog of war. One such letter, believed to be written by a soldier lost in the Battle of Gettysburg, tells of the fear only a soldier can understand. He is known only as Ephraim.
My dear Starletta, I regret that I have not written as much as I should like. We received word that our regiment is to move northwards in the morning. I cannot possibly relate to you the things that I have seen, nor would I want to, for it would haunt your dreams as well as your waking hours as it has done mine. We've been days without a meal proper. We ache. Our boots are filled with blood by the end of a day's hike. I have had to punch holes into my belt to keep it useful. Get so a body can't be sure if he even wants to remain. Some of us are beginning to envy our fallen. But not me, Arletta. For I believe this is a testament to that. If you would honor me a dying wish, send this letter to five of your closest loved ones so that my story can be told. Write it in your own dear hand, Arletta, and enclose a gift that could only possess but a portion of your beauty. And it would please me greatly if you would ask them to do the same. Our captain had written a letter asking his beloved Bess to do the same. But his wishes were not granted in a timely fashion. 3 days, if memory serves. And by all accounts, he remains among the missing. Should I not survive, I must only presume that you reckon this letter was written jest. But I knowed when I left you in April that your love rang true. And when this mockery of humanity is past, and I am alive to see your face once more, I shall tell you in person that your sending of these five letters and gifts was not in vain, and that these letters and gifts, which must be sent within 3 days, though may at first seem to be mighty expense, being no less than equivalent to a month's pay, will allow you to reap greater rewards, both here and in the hereafter. My safety rests in your hands, my beloved. Ephraim, February 13th, 1863. Postage due upon receipt.